Hey guys, this is Chirag Jain from ACM chapter IIT Assam Dhanbad. Today I will show you how you can build a website in React.js for quizzing. So let us see how our website will look at the end of this video. Here is the home page of the website, and you can see a play quiz button, and when you click on it, the quiz will open and you will get 100 seconds to complete the quiz, and each question has 4 options. You can add more options also. Next option, you can select and you can choose any option, and you can select next, previous, and after you submit the quiz or the time is over, you will get your score. And also the correct answer and explanation of each question will be displayed separately. You can go and visit and check what was the correct answer and what was the explanation behind that for every question. Okay. The prerequisite for this project is that you should know HTML, basics of CSS and JavaScript, and if you know React.js, then it is better. Otherwise, I will explain you the concepts of React which we will use. And also you must have Node.js installed, otherwise you can install from this website nodejs.org. You can check your node version by using the command node-v. You will get your version, and npm-v will give the version of npm. So I have 12.16.1 and 16.13.4 as the node and npm versions. You can try these commands in your terminal, or if you are using Windows, then try these commands in your command prompt. Okay. Now we will use the command npx create react app to create our new app, and we will just name any project name, like we will say react quiz. Okay, so this will be the name of our project, and it will create a folder inside this folder only, and it will install the necessary modules which will be required for this project. So it will take some time. Once done, it will create a folder named React Quiz here, because I gave the name of our project as React Quiz. Okay, so now just cd into this directory, cd React Quiz, and enter the command yarn start. It will start the React app in our browser, so we can see this is the React app which React provides, so that we can develop our project using this. And it shows edit scrc app.js and save to view. The specialty is that when we will edit our files, automatically it will reload, and we don't need to again and again quit and again open that project to view the changes. It will automatically reload whenever we will make any changes in the code. So let us see that. Just open your command prompt or terminal and open this folder in your editor. I am using VS Code, so I will use the command code dot. So it will open VS Code. In VS Code, just view the file structure of this project. In React Quiz, we have scrc folder which will contain the main programming js files, and the public folder will contain only one html file. In this index.html file, if you observe, then you will find that there is only one div tag and no other content, and that has an id equals to root. Observe this, and you open the scrc folder. In that, open app.js and open index.js. In index.js, just read this: React DOM root render React, in that there is an app tag, and it gives document.getElementById root. What does it do? It actually does that it replaces the content of the root tag by this. Now what is this? You can just remove this stuff, it is unnecessary for us now. Just place this app tag. Okay, so what does it do? It imports the app from .app, means this app.js file. From this app is a function, you can see. So this app, we can call it as a component. So it will import the component in this file, and it will replace the content of root tag by this app component. So and if you want to import any CSS file, then you can simply import like this, import index.css. okay, now let me show you one thing. In app.js, I remove all this stuff. And I just write home and save. And open your browser, you will see that The whole content is replaced by home automatically. I did not do anything to quit that again and yarn start again. It will automatically reload the changes. Okay. So now we will start making our app. Now let us get a background for our home page. It looks quite ugly. So I have an images folder, one image. So I will just copy this folder into our public folder. Okay. I have copied this here. Okay. Now in index.html just make a link tag here. Link rel equals to style sheet type equals to text.css text by css href equals to dot slash styles.css. I will create this file now. Just create a file here, styles.css. In this, we will try to make our background of HTML and body as the background image that we have now. It will be background image URL slash images slash dark bg and background size cover. Let us see, is there any change? Yeah, the background is ready. So now we will start with the basics of React. You should know what a component is. So first of all, I will tell you that a component is a part of a web page or a website. Okay, so it is not necessary that a component is an entire page. Like we can see the example of our home page. This is our suppose home component. So home component is made up of header, some content is there, and some footer. So these three are three components we can say, and you will know more when we start coding. The thing you must know, what is a prop? Prop is basically a property of a component. Like we can see here, we have created a child component, const child component equals to, and we will always pass the props as an argument. And whenever we will use that component, suppose I have used in some another parent component. So here I have used it like an HTML tag simply. So child component name equals to first child. So what is this? This is the prop of child component, and the name of prop is name, and the value of the prop is first child. So whenever we will display the name like props.name, it will be the value of this, the first child. In this way, we can use the props to display variables in our components. And one thing you must always remember is the props of a component are always constant. We should not modify this prop. Let us come to state of a component. The state of a component is a variable of a component which can only be modified by that particular component which owns it. So you can see here we have created a component example in the form of a function, and we have declared a state in the as using the syntax const count comma set count equals to use state 0. So here count is the name of our state. Set count is a function which we will use to modify the value of count. You can give any other name also to this function. And inside this use state, you will pass the initial value of your state as an argument. Like I want the counter to start from 0, so I will pass 0 as the initial value. And whatever content you want to return through this function, inside that, whenever you are using the state, just place your variable inside curly braces. Okay, so like I have put a text here, you clicked, and inside curly braces I have placed count and times. So what it will do, like count is 0, so it will display you clicked 0 times in this way. And whenever you want to change the value of count, just use set count, like set count, and inside that pass the new value which you want. Like I want to increment the count by 1, so count plus 1 I will pass inside this. Now let us begin by installing some npm modules which we will need for our project. So just enter the command npm I, and the name of the modules are Bootstrap we will need. We will need React Strap, and we will need React Popper, which is a dependency for these two modules. Okay. Once you have installed these modules, then you will see that in the package.json file, we will have React Popper, React Strap, and Bootstrap. These modules are present. Now let us create a header for our home page. In the src folder, create a folder components. Inside components, create a folder header.js, which will contain our header component. So we will use the navbar of React Strap here. So just go to the original documentation of React Strap, and inside that go to components, and you will find navbar here. So I will be using this navbar, which look like this. So just copy this stuff. I will make you understand each and everything why it is present like that. So we have imported React, and we will use the use state to maintain the state of our header component. And let us name this component as not an example, but it is a header. Export default header. So this component will be exported from this file. Now we have created is open a variable, a state of this component, and a function set is open. So what this function will do, it will change the value of this state. So we have created a function toggle to change this state by calling this set is open. So it will call this set is open and will negate the value of our state is open. So we have created a navbar, and we have called this toggle function on click whenever the user clicks on the toggle button. This will be visible only on below empty devices, means medium sized devices, you can say tablets and mobile phones. Let us edit the header. In the navbar brand, just write quizzer or any name of your website, and we can remove this part. This nav item is unnecessary for now. Just close this nav tag. Now we will just simply put a quiz, href equals to quiz, and we will here write play quiz, and you will see that we have not used these components from React Strap. So we will remove this. We have used only collapse, navbar, and these only components we have used from React Strap. So we will keep these, and I think it's okay now. So just import this header component inside your app component. How we will import? Just simply write import header from dot slash components slash header dot js, or simply header. Now you can use this header as a simple HTML tag. Like I will write header and just close it. Let us see what it looks. Just make sure that you have yarn start in your terminal. So it will open the app in our browser. So, but here we see that it doesn't look as expected. As shown in the documentation, it doesn't look like that. So actually we forgot one thing. We need to include the React Strap dependency, the Bootstrap library, or the Bootstrap framework. Here just write import Bootstrap dist css, and Bootstrap CSS file is bootstrap.min.css. Just include this and let us see what changes there. Now it appears something. Now we need to change the color to a dark color because we have a darker theme here. So just go to the header component. In header, just replace this light prop by dark prop. We can see that it is a prop. It is not HTML, so we'll not call it as an attribute, but we will call it a prop. And color will be black. And let us see the navbar. Now it looks perfect. Another thing you should notice that whenever you will open this website in a smaller device, here a toggler button will appear, which will toggle the menu. Okay. So this is due to our changing of the state in the header component. You can see the documentation of React Strap. Here you will observe that there are many props related to navbar, like light, dark, fixed, color. So we used the dark prop here. You can use many more, and you can find the various components here like fade, collapse, jumbotron layout, buttons, and everything. We will use some of these in our project. These are basically related to Bootstrap. So if you have used Bootstrap in any of your previous projects, so it will be similar to that. Okay. Let's create another component called our quiz component, where our questions will be displayed. So I'm creating a quiz.js file, and here we will create in a similar pattern, import React from React, and just name your component function quiz, pass props, and return empty div. Currently we will return empty div and we will work on it, and export default quiz so that it will be exported and it can be used in another components. Now for the quiz component, first of all we will create a timer. So for a timer we will be requiring the time as a state. So I will just mention const time, and I will write a function set time equals to use state, and the initial time will be say 100 seconds. This time is time remaining, so it is the time remaining for the user to submit the quiz. Now we want that the time state of our component should decrement by 1 after every second. For this we will be using set timeout function, and that too we will be using in a use effect function of React. What it does, I will tell you. In use effect we pass a callback function. In the callback function I will pass a function which will be calling the set timeout function, so that n is equal to 1000 milliseconds. So I am passing 1000 as an argument, and I will pass another callback function which will be calling the set time function, set time and time minus 1. So the time will be decrementing by 1 after 1 second, but I want that after 1 second the time has become 99, but it should become 98 after 2 seconds. So I mean this set timeout should be called repetitively. So the use effect function is such that it always gets called whenever the component is re-rendered. Components in React are re-rendered whenever any of the state changes, like we have changed the time state, so it will be re-rendering that time. So here we want that this function inside the use effect should be called only when the time state is changed. So it has a second argument, which is an array of states, which you want that whenever these states are changed, this use state function callback should be called. So I have passed time, so whenever the time state will change, this will call this callback function. But here also we will require another condition, that whenever the time becomes 0, we don't want to decrement it now. So if time equals to 0, we can do one thing, we will create another state for maintaining the activeness of the contest, means it shows whether the quiz is active or it has stopped. So active and set active I will use, and initially that will be true, means the quiz is active, but whenever the time is completed it active will be false and it will be showing time up. So it will be for just state of the quiz. Okay, so if time equals to 0 we will use set active to set the state as false. Note that here you can't write just simply that active equals to false. This will not be working as expected. Why? Because in React whenever you change the value of a state you need to call the set function, otherwise what will happen is the component will not be re-rendered. Although the value will be changed, the state will be changed, but the component with the new state will not be re-rendered, so it will be of no use. So we will not write simply active equals to false, and we will use the set active function to update the state. Now let's create a timer component, and before that just here I am using some Bootstrap classes to contain that timer component. So here I will write class dev class name equals to container. Here one thing you must notice, that I am not using dev class equals to container, I am using class name. So it is something different from HTML. In HTML you could have written simply class equals to container, but in React you need to use class name equals to container because class is a reserved keyword in React, so you can't use that. Okay, so after this I will write div class equals to class name equals to row. It is a bootstrap class for declaring a row, and inside that I am writing class name equals to call12. You can also use flexbox to give a flex structure to your program, but I am using ready-made bootstrap classes so as to save our time. Now after this, let us create a timer component just before this quiz component. I will write function timer. Notice that I am writing T in capital. You can't write it in small because you are creating your own component. So React has a rule that whenever you create your own component, you need to write the beginning of it in the first capital letter. This timer component will have a single prop. We can call it time, similar to the quiz component. It will be the same state of quiz component, which will be passed to this component as a prop. You will see in a few seconds. Now it is a prop, so I will just write const time equals to props. This is a destructuring syntax in JavaScript you might be familiar with. And now we will just return div class name equals to container. We will use React strap progress bar. So just search for progress, you will get this progress bar. Just copy paste the progress div class name equals to text enter and this thing here. And instead of this 25%, I will write the variable time. Also, I told you earlier that you need to write the variables in curly braces, so remember that. And here also value equals to time. So this will be varying according to our use effect function. Now we need to pass the props to this timer component and just render it in our quiz component. So I will just use similar to HTML syntax. T should be in capital, timer. The time prop of this component will be equal to the time state of our quiz component. So I will just pass it this way. And now we will use this quiz component in our app.js. Just import this quiz from ./components/quiz or quiz.js you can write. And just below this header, similar to HTML syntax, just write quiz and close the tag. Now let us. So in the browser, it shows these errors. Progress is not defined, use state is not defined. So just go to quiz.js and we need to import progress from React strap because we imported from there. Progress from React strap. And use effect is there. And also we need to import the use state function because we used it here. Use straight from React. Now it should work fine. Let us see. Okay, the timer is decreasing, 100, 99, 88, like this. But we want it in the reverse way, so just I will pass 100 minus time. So it will work in the reverse way. And also just to see how it works, just I will pass initial time as 5 seconds in the use state. Now let us see. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and it is done. To make it look better, you can just set the color as danger. Danger is a bootstrap color, don't worry. So just set the color of progress to danger. It should become red like. So I think it will match with our theme. Oh yeah.